Beamform X comes with an extensive amount of introduction and help patchers, which all make use of a visualizer that's included with the package. But what if we want to work with real lights? On the table we have two Showtech Kenyo Spot 10s. This fixture uses 10 DMX channels, so we've set their addresses to 1 and 11. Both fixtures are connected to each other with a 3-pin DMX cable, with one of them connected to our DMX's USB interface, which is then connected to our computer with USB. Now let's make sure that Beam will output DMX to the DMX interface. We'll have to open the I/O editor, which we can find under the Extras menu, and depending on whether you've opened the demo set, the visualizer, earlier, then you may already see some entries here. Either way, we can clear our settings by hitting the clear button, and then add our output by hitting the plus. Considering we have a USB interface, let's choose the USB output option and select the DMX's device. We only have one of these. It can only output one universe, which is number 0, and it will output whatever is in Beam's universe number 1. It appears online as it's already connected to our machine. We can save our settings to a JSON file down here, but we don't really have to, as these settings will be remembered next time we launch Max. Now that we have our hardware output set up, let's add our fixtures to our patch using the patch editor, which we can find under the Extras menu. Again, depending on whether you've opened the demo set, we may already see something in this list, but let's clear it and hit the plus icon. We'll have to find our fixture profile for the Showtech Kenyo Spot 10 in this drop-down menu, and once we do, the name field is automatically populated, but we can change it if we wish. This fixture profile in particular only has one DMX mode, but other profiles may have multiple modes to choose from. We have two fixtures, and we want them to be in Universe 1, since that's what's being fed to the DMX's interface. The starting address for our first spot is 1, so we can leave this as it is. A fundamental part of Beam is the tagging system. We'll dive into that more in another video, but for now we can add both our fixtures to the same tag by naming it something like Kenyos, and add the fixtures to our patch. We can then select the individual fixtures in our list and test them. They seem to be working, so that means we can start with our Max patch. But before we do, it's good to know that our patch in this window will be reset next time we launch Max. In other words, we will have to save our patch if we want to reuse it later. We can do so manually with the cursor, or we can do so in our patch using the beam.core object. As we can see in the help patcher, we can get and set the patch and I/O settings with this object. Beam.core does not need to be present in the patch for Beam to work though. It is simply an object that allows us to interact with Beam's engine, which runs in the background. But back to our Kenyos. We need a beam.output object to send our lighting data to. Next, we will need beam.tag, and we can give it Kenyos as an argument, as that's the tag we created earlier. This is our way of selecting a group of fixtures that we want control over. If we right-click on the left inlet of beam.tag, we can see the available parameters for the fixtures within this tag. Let's start with the obvious, dim. Just a simple message box and a float object, and this already allows us to set the dim for both fixtures in this tag. If we want to address individual fixtures within a tag, we can use a list, where each value represents the fixture we want to control. To control pan or tilt, all we need to do is change the message we send into beam.tag. Beam4Max also comes with dedicated objects for lighting control with MSP and MC audio signals and jitter mattresses, but that's for another video.